ओके, गुड आफ्टरनून
गुड आफ्टरनून गुड
आफ्टरनून
देयर इज ओनली अ वेरी स्मॉल पोर्शन लेफ्ट इन दिस चैप्टर सो वी विल क्विकली फिनिश दैट अप ओके एंड वी विल सी द रिव्यू क्वेश्चंस आल्सो आफ्टर दैट सो टुडे वी सॉ अबाउट एडल्टहुड एन एडल्ट इज जनरली डिफाइंड एज समवन हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल मैच्योर सेल्फ सपोर्टिंग एंड वेल इंटीग्रेटेड इन द सोसाइटी आई होप दैट टॉपिक इज क्लियर एंड अंडर दैट वी सॉ द मेन चैलेंजेस दैट एन इंडिविजुअल इज फेसिंग इन द एडल्टहुड स्टेज वी सॉ अबाउट कैरियर एंड वर्क देन मैरिज पेरेंटहुड एंड फैमिली वॉट आर द डिफरेंट opinions that people have about it what are the different concerns that people have about each of this topic we discussed that in the previous class now we're moving on to the next one that is old age okay which was the first stage of development that we studied
prenatal stage
prenatal stage prenatal yes very good usually everybody says it's infancy there is a stage before we are born isn't it that development is also one among the most you know crucial stage of human development so that is prenatal stage after prenatal we saw infancy then we came to childhood then adolescence and finally adulthood and this is the last one old age now Again, this is the thing. Just when old age begins, it is not easy to determine. We can't just say that at this particular age you become to the, you become the category of old age people. And even some people who become middle age, even they feel like they have become old because they start having gray hairs. Then they maybe we saw physical differences physical changes that happens isn't it in the last class adulthood changes yes even when that happens when they gain weight when they become more tired very often they feel like they have come to this old age group okay they start to worry about their future that's a problem so we cannot actually say when this old age begins but It's again a just like any other human developmental stage. It's a bit complicated too. So let's see. So in this section also, we'll be looking into different challenges that people face in this set of changes or developmental changes that happens in the last and final stage of old age. So one among them is retirement. Retirement is a very crucial stage for especially the elderly people the old aged people and again when we look from multiple perspectives depending on the people depending on the situations in which or depending on the circumstances around this person obviously the viewpoints towards retirement will be different far different there'll be striking contrast between two people if we take examples isn't it one can actually be very happy about the retirement like they can spend that time with their grandchildren or with their children or they can spend time traveling around the world they can be more productive maybe they have a passion which they did not even look into because of their work so after retirement they can improve that they can get involved in that more often So there is a positive side for it, and obviously, if it is if the retirement is with pension, obviously they'll be satisfied and happy, isn't it? Yes. And if the work was the work years was a burden for them, obviously stopping that work will be again a relief for them. Okay, and it's a period where they can actually look into their own health, they can improve their own health. Follow all the medical regimes properly because they don't have other work pressures or something like that. Okay, so that is one side of it. For another set of people, like if they are living alone, if they are widows or widower, that is one problem. That is, they feel that they are very much lonely. So obviously, all these psychological problems, health and related health problems might occur: depression, anxiety, too much worry about the future. Who will be there to look after me? Like when I was, I'm the person, if I'm going for work, obviously my colleagues are there. Isn't it? Like if some medical condition occurs in between the daytime or in between the work hours, they'll be there. At least for that time, they'll be there. But if I'm staying alone at home after retirement, obviously, I'll be worried about that fact also. And then for some people, it's like a very unproductive stage or an unproductive day. They become or they belong to an unproductive state. They feel so. Because there is no more contribution that I can give. But there are other contributions that they can give. It's not really, understood by them. Okay, that is in the case of some people alone. This one problem, retirement, then widowhood, as I told you. Again, loneliness, depression, all those problems might happen. Then illness, a major issue. Yes, I've heard many people who belong to this young adulthood say that when you enter the middle adulthood or you enter the late adulthood, obviously you'll have some or the other disease like diabetes, very common, diabetes mellitus or hypertension or maybe thyroid problem, thyroid imbalances, then these cognitive problems like memory problems and all. You might start to have. So why should we worry from now on? We can have as much as we can. Cholesterol, then this blood pressure, all these problems are very common because of the lifestyle and the food styles of people. Okay. So it is usually said that in old age, there is a stigma, I would say. Not all individuals who belong to old age have illness, isn't it? There are people who actually maintain their health, go for a walk or maybe go for jogging in the morning or evening walks and take care of their health. They remain fit. Not only in the physical fitness, it also boosts their mental fitness too, mental health. So illness is related to both the physical as well as psychological. Okay. And death in the family, again, not only of the spouse, but also maybe a child, maybe the sibling, maybe their own parents. All these factors can also influence their emotional, socio-emotional, to be frank, then physical health, then the whole mental health also. Okay, so these are the main points that are discussed here. So let's read from the text again. Take page number 81. Okay. So old age. Meryl, can you start reading?
Just when old age begins, it's not easy to determine. Traditionally, the age of retirement was linked to old age. Now that people are living longer, age of retiring from work is changing, and the cutoff point for the definition of old age is moving upward. Some of the challenges which the aged have to cope with include retirement, widowhood, illness, or death in the family. The image of old age is changing in certain ways. Now there are people who have crossed 70 years of age or so and are quite active, energetic, and creative. They are competent and they therefore valued by the society in many walks of life. In particular, we have aged people in politics, literature, business, art and science. The myth of old age as an incapacitating and therefore frightening phase of life is changing.
Yes, so there is a change in the viewpoint towards old age. Like generally it was considered as a very unproductive stage. The stage of human development where we have to sit and wait for our death because it's a final stage. There is nothing much to do or nothing else to do again. That was the conception, misconception, I would say. Okay, but now, not now, in the recent years, it has been changing. And we have seen, our societies have seen a lot of individuals who belong to this old age who have excelled in different dimensions, not only dimensions, different directions also, like in different fields too, like business, it can be art, science, anything. politics, especially politics. After retirement, they might enter politics, isn't it? Yeah. So these are these viewpoints about the negative viewpoints specifically. These negative viewpoints have been changing throughout the years. Okay. Then Amal Roshan, did you say something in between?
I said we should not sit in the home. We should make money for the son.
We are talking about old age after retirement.
I saw one doctor who was making more money for the son.
For what?
He's 85 years, but he's now practicing.
Still practicing. Okay, yes. That's the way people are being productive. It's not necessary that they are being productive by earning money. But they can do a lot of...
Then I asked him, he told that we should not think about that. How should we should life and we should exercise, he told.
Yes.
He told that you should not simply sit in the home and what the sons are telling about, you should do that. You should earn and you should live.
Yes. Even at old age, we have to be self-sufficient. That's the thing. Okay. So next paragraph. Mary, can you read?
Yes, ma'am. Of course, the experience of old age also depends on the socio-economic conditions, availability of healthcare, attitude of people, expectations of society, and available support system. Work is most important during adult years. Then family becomes most important, and beyond that becomes the most important issue in the person's life. Clearly, for much of our adult life focuses on how effective we are at work, how active are in our family, how good our friendships are, how healthy we are, and how cognitively fit we are.
Okay, so the thing is, when we consider adulthood and old age together, in the early stages of adulthood, we'll be more concerned about the work. Just like we discussed in the last class, finding a job, dealing with unemployment, dealing with your own job that you already have, then trying to go for a better job, trying to earn more, trying to get incentives, trying to get an increment in the salary, and managing these expenses, then managing the salary or the money that you earn, all these things of becoming really financially independent. That is the focus in the early years of adulthood. And finally, not finally, in the middle portion, you'll focus more on establishing a family, having children, I mean, getting married, having children, and so on. And when you come to the end part means the latter part, then what happens is more focus is given on health. The thing is not, the more importance is not for earning so much money or looking after the family, but remaining healthy. If the person is fit, then only they can do other productive things, isn't it? So health becomes the importance later on in life. That is a point highlighted here. So please underline that point. Of course, the experience of old age also depends on the socioeconomic conditions. Availability of healthcare, that is the healthcare facilities available. Or if somebody falls sick, if an elderly person falls sick, does this person have anybody around to look after this person, or are the medical facilities available around this person, and can the person afford to pay for this money and the medical expenses, all those things. Then attitude of people around these people, like some people consider the elderly people at home as a burden, isn't it? And because of that, they put them into what?
People tell that he should die. Why he is eating my money?
Yeah, there are even cruel people who think like that. But I'm asking, when they think that they can't take care of the elderly people in the house, what will they do? Where would they send them?
Old age homes.
Yes, old age homes or elderly homes. Okay. Then we also have care homes, like daycares for children, isn't it? The daytime they'll be taken care of by somebody else, that is nurses. And after that, during night time, they'll be brought back, something like that. Arrangements might be made. I'm not telling that all the people are doing this on purpose because they want to get rid of these people. Maybe because of the circumstances, like they don't have anybody at home, all the children are working, so these old fathers and mothers are alone at home. So that's a big risk, isn't it? If they have health issues, obviously it is a risk. So they might assign them to some other care homes. Okay. Then what else is discussed here? Expectations of society and the available support system. There is a societal factors around. So all these factors influences their whole development in the old age. These are the socio-economic condition. That's why I told you to underline. Okay. Then next paragraph. Happy now? Can you read? Abhinav. No. Anila.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Read that paragraph. Retirement from active vocational life. Page number 81. Are you there? No. Devika.
Ma'am, topic.
Devika, sound is not audible to me. Anila, topic is retirement from active vocational life. The third paragraph on the right side, page 81. Can you all please switch on your videos? No? Devika, try once more. I was not able to hear you. No. Emeline? It's okay. Emeline?
Retirement from active vocational life is quite significant. Some people perceive retirement as a negative change. They consider it as a separation from an important source of satisfaction and self-esteem. Others view it as a shift in life with more times to pursue their own interest. It seems that the older adults who shows openness to the new experience, more stringing and achievement. Orientation behavior prefer to keep busy and a better adjustment.
Better adjustment. It's the same thing that we discussed in the beginning. Okay, about retirement. Different people have different opinions on it and different viewpoints. And the experiences that these people go through are also different. Then older adults also need to adjust to changes in the family structure and new roles, that is grandparenting, that have to be learned. Children usually are busy in their careers and families and may set up independent homes. Older adults may depend on their children for financial support and to overcome their loneliness after children have moved out. This might trigger off feelings of hopelessness and depression in some people. Like if their own children are moving away to some other independent home, like maybe to a new country. So they'll be again left alone at home, isn't it? So even after retirement, if they're again alone, they don't have anything to do, so obviously these negative thoughts will come to their mind. So that might lead to depression, anxiety, and all the psychological disorders possible. So that is one issue. Then they have to learn new roles, that is especially grandparenting. If the grandchildren are living with them, then obviously we have to learn new roles. That is another point discussed here. Then, in old age, feeling of loss of energy and dwindling of health and financial assets lead to insecurity and dependency. And one dependency is based on the financial dependence. sometimes if they don't get pension and if they are retired, then obviously they'll be dependent on the children for money, especially money, isn't it? Yes. The elderly tend to look towards others to lean on and to care for them. Indian culture favors dependency of elderly on their children for old age needs caring. Underline that. In Indian culture, we follow a collectivistic form of culture, a collectivistic viewpoint. That is, we are too much engaged with the collection of people around us. And because of that, there is an expectancy from the children. They are expected to take care of their parents when they become old. It's a usual thing followed in India, especially in India. Okay, and most of the Asian countries, it is like that. We follow collectivistic culture, but Western, it is different. It is individualistic culture. Okay, and there the parents as well as children, they learn to be independent of each other. Okay, then in fact, parents in most Oriental cultures rear their children with a fond hope that they'll care for them during old age. It is important to give the elderly a sense of security and belonging, a feeling that people care for them, especially in time of crisis, and to remember that we all have to grow old one day. They have to be spoken to. And the fact that obviously we all have to die at some point of time, isn't it? That is the nature's law. And obviously they'll have so much of worry about this concept called death. And now if I say we can die at any age, it's not actually old age alone, isn't it? So we have to openly talk to them, especially the elderly people. They'll be worried about this topic, about this concept. So they have to be spoken to about this whole thing. Then, although death is more likely to occur in late adulthood, death can come at any point in development. That is the main thing. So next portion is regarding death, how death is perceived in different cultures, how cultural differences occur in the concept of death. That is the next two paragraphs. The deaths, especially of children and younger adults, are often perceived to be more tragic than those of others. That we all know. Because when we reach old age, we say that was destined to, isn't it? Because we have reached that stage. But if it is of children, especially small children, it's very heartbreaking, isn't it? Yes. So then, in children and younger adults, death is more likely to occur because of accidents. But in older adults, it is more likely to occur because of chronic diseases. Main reasons for death. Now, death of a spouse is usually seen as the most difficult loss. Underline that, death of a spouse. It is seen as a most significant loss among people and the most difficult to deal with. Those left behind after the death of their partner suffer deep grief, cope with loneliness, depression, financial loss, and are also at risk of many health-related problems. These are the problems that might occur to a partner who has lost the spouse or the partner. Then, widows by far outnumber widowers because studies show that women live longer than men and tend to marry men older than themselves. Okay. Then, during such times, again, this is regarding Indian culture. The majority is regarding Indian culture. Then, during such times, support from children, grandchildren, and friends can help the individual cope with the loss of spouse. Again, we all know that. I'm not explaining anymore. It's a common topic. Now, the next one is about the death. People in different cultures view death differently. There are two cultures mentioned here. One is Gond culture. The other one is Tanala culture. Okay. And in Gond culture, it is described that death is caused by magic and demon. Some demonic powers causes this death. Then in Tanala culture, it is said that death is caused by natural forces. And We all are following a scientific method, isn't it? Even for our education, everything. Yes. So we have learned a lot of science. So obviously we know that there is a definite cause for death. It's not, we do not follow much of superstition. We know that it might be because of some heart failure, or maybe because of some other organ problem, because of some terminal illness, because of a chronic disease and so on. Okay, because of brain death, accidents. We clearly can know the scientific basis of that death. But in different cultures, this concept of death has different meaning. That is given in the last paragraph. So people in different cultures view death differently. In the Gond culture in our country, it is believed that death is caused by magic and demon. Now, Tanala culture, it is of Madagascar. Tanala culture is from Madagascar. They say that natural forces are thought to cause death. That is in Tanala culture. And human development, as you have read in this chapter, thus helps you to understand the influence of various factors in an individual's lifetime. The end. Okay. Let me take a long breath. This was a very long chapter, isn't it? Didn't you feel so? I felt so because this is the chapter that I hate the most to teach and to study also.
Very sad about the death things.
You're very sad about the death. Everybody is very sad about the death. Last day, one of my friend's pet dog passed away. And he was literally in depression, grieving so much. And I was also like, what happened to this guy? And our friends called, not him, but the other friends called me and told me he's very sad, do something. So and so happened. And it was a, the dog was, it was a dog. It was bought, I think, a few days before to home. Okay. And with so much of passion, this guy bought this dog, and finally it was infected by some virus and finally passed away. And to get a relief, he went to the gym, it seems. But there also he was sitting in a corner and crying. Crying means the eyes all were full of tears. And finally, our other set of friends tried to console him. And he told he don't want to go home. If he go home, he'll again get the memories. So obviously, he don't want to go there again. And yeah, that's what happened. We all grieve, isn't it? After death, it is a usual process. We should. That is the grieving process after death is a common process. We should do that. We should vent out our feelings. Otherwise, it is again an emotional burden inside us. Okay, there is a time period for grieving. If the grieving continues after this period, obviously we'll require counseling or other psychotherapy. That's when we go to the edge where we might fall into depression and anxiety and related disorders. Okay, Amarashan, it's very common and very normal to be sad. There is no problem with that. If you are born as a human, obviously you can, you have to experience both happiness as well as sorrow, isn't it? Yes, that's what brings the balance in life. If you have happiness all the time, what is the thrill? Ups and downs gives you the thrill. Yes. So shall we discuss the review questions also? And we'll finish this off. Page number 83. Okay, first question. What is development? How is it different from growth and maturation? Development, the direct answer is there. Take the starting page. Direct definition is given for development, page number 65. Okay, and growth means it's related to the physical sense. the increase in the physical characteristics like height, weight and all. And that can be quantified also. Like you can measure your height, you can measure your weight, isn't it? That's related to growth. Then for maturation or maturity, what is asked here? Maturation, right? You can write a line and keep. In the textbook itself, you can write. I'll read out. Maturation refers to the changes. Maturation refers to the changes. Maturation refers to the changes that follow and that follow and that follow and that follow an orderly sequence that follow an orderly sequence that follow an orderly sequence and are largely dictated by the 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 genetic blueprint dictated by the genetic blueprint which produces genetic blueprint which produces genetic blueprint which produces commonalities in our growth and development commonalities right com c o commonalities commonalities in our growth and development in our growth and development till what time is the class
2:50
no okay Second question, describe the main features of lifespan perspective on development. Yes, tell me, lifespan perspective, a story. Tell me one by one.
Ma'am, development is lifelong.
Development is lifelong. Lifelong.
Slip it is the process of human development.
Remember the 7 points. I'm asking that.
Ma'am, it is multi-directional.
Multi-directional.
Ma'am, before that, interwoven.
Interwoven. That is a different process in it are interwoven. Then.
Highly plastic.
Highly plastic.
Development was influenced by the historical conditions.
Then then historical conditions then
ma'am discipline discipline
it involves various or it's a concern for it concerns various other disciplines psychology and all comes under that then Last one.
The response acts on contexts.
Context is wrong. Context. 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 Yes. Okay. There are 7 points, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 points in the lifespan perspective. LSP. Remember, lifespan perspective also called LSP. Then what are developmental tasks explained by giving examples developmental tasks again is a direct thing given in the text okay that bolded letters is already given then examples also you can write from any of the human development stages developmental tasks then Environment of the child has a major role in the development of the child. Support your answer with examples. Yes. Do you think environment has a major role? Or the surroundings has a major role in the development of a human being or a child? Yes or no? No?
Yes.
Yes.
Mom.
No.
I told yes.
You told yes. Okay. So the points coming under contextual views, it can be highlighted there. Okay. Contextual view of development. That is based on the the context or the environment in which the child lives in. Okay. Then what is? How do sociocultural factors influence development? Sociocultural factors. Again, that is also given just before we started. Yeah, overview of developmental stages. Before that, we have it. The visible and the surrounding layer factors, all those factors, you can generalize and write. Okay, how the sociocultural context of individuals influence them. Then discuss the cognitive changes taking place in a developing child. That is Piaget's theory. We learned only Piaget's cognitive development theory. It's clearly given in that box. So box, that is table 4.2, page number 72. Mark it and keep. Okay. Then question number 7, attachment bonds formed in childhood years have long-term effects. Explain taking examples from daily life. So you can explain about attachment. Then if you want, you can include depending upon the marks. If it is a long essay question, obviously you can write that attachment experiment that we learned. Remember the surrogate mother and the other mother, birth mother. Yes, so that's it. Question number 8 is, what is adolescence? Explain the concept of egocentrism. That is, it is asked along with adolescence. So obviously, you have to write about two main concepts by David Elkind. What were they? Special type of egocentrism present in adolescence. What is it? There were two points.
Personal fables and imaginary audience.
Imaginary audience and personal fable. Okay. You have to define adolescence. You can write more characteristics about it. It's a transition period. There's a period of stress, confusions, a period of identity formation, all those things. Then you can write. Again, this is also based on marks. If it is a 2-mark question, you have to write at least four or five sentences. Okay, but it's a long essay question. Obviously, you have to explain and elaborate and write all the factors asked in the question. Then, what are the factors influencing the formation of identity during adolescence? Support your answer with examples. Again, identity formation, there are different factors like culture. Can be culture. Then it can be the peer group. Then it can be parents, the teachers, the school environment. Then increased interaction with the environment, the social media. Then, these are the main factors that influence identity formation during adolescence. And that is given in page number 78, forming an identity. Mostly the last paragraph speaks about the main factors that influences the identity formation. 10th question is, what are the challenges faced by individuals on entry to adulthood? It's a direct question today we saw about it, isn't it? Career, work, then marriage, parenthood, establishing a family, and doing all of the responsibilities. These are the main points. So that's it. And that is given in page number 80. Okay, so we are done with the chapter. I'll send you the notes. Attendance. Abdul Hasif was present here. Abhinav?
Present, ma'am.
Alina Jason? Alina Varghese? Manila? Devika?
Present, ma'am.
Emeline?
Present, ma'am.
Eva has not come. Then Malavika?
Yes, ma'am.
Mary?
Yes, ma'am.
Meryl?
Present, ma'am.
Then Rose?
Present, ma'am.
Shreya?
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Abhiram? Was he present, Abhiram? No. Okay. Abhijit? Abhijit was present, no? Abhilash?
Present.
Amal Roshan?
Present, ma'am.
Kazuri? Kevin? Omar? Sanam? Sandra? Sanjana?
Present, ma'am.
Nestle? Okay. So thank you. If you have any doubts, please feel free to contact me. Thank you. Happy weekend.
Thank you.